So let's meet our new Allure BLR by Baby Lock. She is our newest little baby, and she is our most affordable sewing machine that also embroiders. You're going to love her. Let's start with the really basics, like threading the machine. How easy is this? This tells me exactly where to go and what to do. One, make a U-turn. Two, now come down. Make a U-turn around number three. Come up to number four here. Go across, pull down. At number five, lower the presser foot, and then reach back and hook the thread in that last little thread guide. It's labeled number six. You probably can't see it. Now I look for a little V here and this area right here, and that's number seven. I basically guide my thread and slide it into number seven, reach back to number eight, and cut, and then this is how I thread the machine. Eyes closed, it's done. Okay, so we're going to put a bobbin into our new Allure BLR. There's a little rectangle right here. Push to the right, that flips the little clear cover off the machine. Place the bobbin in the machine, and actually you can hardly see it, but kind of carved into the bobbin area is a diagram that shows me exactly how to lay that bobbin in. There are arrows here, and there's an arrow here that tells me just to come this way, and when I pull, it just cuts the bobbin thread off. I'm going to replace the bobbin cover, and now we're ready to sew. I have arrows left and right that will take me through the various stitches, and when I choose any particular stitch, it comes up preset with the manufacturer's default settings for length and width and all of that. And I have found that 99% of the time, what I choose on the machine is set up just perfectly for my needs. Do you see this button right here in the front of the machine? It's green right now, and it says start and stop. I'm going to just touch it, and the machine will start stitching. The speed control is up here, and that gives me my speed. When I want to stop, I can just push the stop button and it stops. Yes, I could plug in the foot control and I could be squeezing my foot down and up like a traditional sewing machine, but this start-stop feature has become one of the most asked for features on modern machines. It just makes your sewing easier. This machine has a needle positioner. I have chosen to set it in the up position, so every time I come to a stop, that needle will be up and my fabric will be free and clear. If I wanted the needle to stop down, I've got two choices. I could tap this button and that would give me needle down on demand. Now, if I'm doing a lot of sewing and I say to myself, you know, I would really rather have this needle always stop in the down position, I can go into my settings screen and change my needle up position to needle down position so that now whenever I stop the machine, that needle will stop down. Another thing they've given to us is up here. This is our reverse. This is our locking stitch. And a lot of old-fashioned machines used to have the reverse lever over here. Well, we need it right here near our needle. This makes it much easier. In addition, I can come to a stop, and instead of raising the needle, picking up the presser foot, and cutting the thread, do you see on this front here I have a little pair of scissors? Scissors will do two things. Raises a needle, and it cuts the thread. What we have on the Allure BLR is a presser foot lifter, just like normal, but it has an additional punch I give the presser foot lifter. And look how high that presser foot's come up. Now I can take these 12 layers of denim and just sit right down on it, and this machine will just sail right through. How about a couple of layers of the silkiest, slidiest, slipperiest charmeuse silk? I'm going from one to the other. I'm not having to do anything special. So most machines at this point, number one, they wouldn't handle the heavy denim. It'd be groaning quite a bit, wouldn't they? And number two, on this fine, really horrible silk, It'd be gathering and puckering the fabric, and it's perfection. And it's not even using the right needle for any of these fabrics. I kind of fudged on this. This is a flatbed sewing machine in this manner, but when I pull this piece off, the machine turns into a free arm. In addition, bring this forward, this holds all of our presser feet, all of our gadgets. Everything is labeled. Every presser foot has a letter and a cubby, a little garage it lives in. Let me show you what we do to get ready for embroidery. The first thing you're going to do is to take off the accessory case that slides off. And then we're going to take the embroidery unit. This is the embroidery unit. And we're going to slide it onto the machine, making sure that this is open. Can you see this over here? This is open? It's open. Okay, good. Okay. And then we're going to slide this in place until it snaps. Now this is our embroidery hoop. The machine will embroider in a 5x7 format. And that's large. You know, our other baby, our big baby, she'll go up to a 6x10. But most embroidery machines in this caliber, in this price range, only embroider 4x4. So a 5x7 image size is really, really nice to have. We've got an area called exclusives. We've got a little picture of a butterfly. We've got these letters. So as an example, in the letters, if I just tap the box with the letters in them, I've got 6 different alphabet styles to choose from. If I go into the little picture of butterflies, there are, again, lots and lots of stitch choices. Again, using my arrows to the right or left will take me through the various images. This book comes with the machine. And this really does show you in much better detail the variety of the stitches of the embroidery designs that are included with the machine at no extra charge. I've only had a chance to sew out a few of these designs, so I'm just going to show you a couple of things that we've done. This is one, again, where we brought the image in, mirrored it, and brought it in and pushed them close together.